Well, Surface Transforms is a developer of carbon fibre reinforced ceramic products, and it's raising funds just as its order book swells. David Bundred is the chairman. Now, David, you are raising money. Why now?
Quite simply because we have moved on from the technical development stage into the implementation stage. We have a group of customers who want to buy from us, who are love the product, love the technology, but are saying to us, but you've got to get the price right, you've got to get the lead times around, you've got to have a secure supply chain, and you've got to have the capacity. To do that, we need to build a pilot plant.
And how much money are you wanting to raise?
We are seeking to raise $1.5 million in this round.
And tell me again, what are you going to do with that money, every penny?
It splits into literally buying the capital equipment for the plant. We want to bring some processes in-house. We want to improve our machinery in some areas. We want to add capacity in other areas. We already have a plant, of course, but we want to add capacity. And we want to bring processes in-house. But we also want to recruit extra engineers because delivering these products, delivering these programs to our demanding customers requires engineers.
In terms of the products, in a nutshell, does your company make really tough, durable, indestructible brake discs for like cars and aircraft? Is that what you do?
Absolutely, spot on. You've obviously read the marketing material. That's exactly what we do.
But in the past, there was rockets. Brakes. Rockets don't need brakes. You're not really concentrating on the rocket side anymore, are you?
We have little or no. I mean, basically, Surface Transforms started life as a material science company and had an excellent technology that went into a number of areas. But the future of the business is that we are a aerospace automotive business using that material technology to apply it in disc brakes for, as you said, aircraft and high-performance cars.
So in the RNS statements that have been coming out from your company, I've been looking at the phrase, a strengthening of the order book. Who's buying?
Well, the one under contract that is very clearly announced is an important aerospace contract, and that's important at a whole host of levels, mainly because it provides us, but above all, it provides a reference point from a well-known household name, at least household name in the industry, aircraft manufacturer. We're doing, after a pretty rocky start, a pretty rocky period in the retrofit market, that's now climbing again, and we're working with a number of vehicle manufacturers on specific programs on high-performance cars.
So what is the retrofit? Is it for vintage cars?
No, it's not actually. Basically, people like the characteristics of carbon fibre brakes so much, they take their steel brakes off and put carbon fibre brakes on because it gives them better feel, gives them better fuel efficiency, enables them to run the cars faster, and particularly people who race the cars, and so it's the retrofit market.
So you talk about a contract with a household name. Do you have any other game-changing contracts on the horizon?
Very much so. As I've made this clear both in the chairman's statement and in the RNS, we're working with the program managers on four programs, two in the UK, two in Germany. I can't mention the vehicles, not because of price sensitivity or anything like that. It's just that we don't want the competitors to know.
And in terms of competitors not wanting or wanting to know things, are we likely to see any other technological innovations from your company?
Yes, there's one outstanding issue in the whole industry, and it's what we call wet test endurance, and it's about the ability of disc brakes to survive in extremely wet, slushy, muddy, dirty conditions. It's a slightly artificial test as it happens, but you know, good car manufacturers over engineer their products. We know one of our competitors can do it, we know that another one can't, but we can do it and are actually demonstrating this to the customers at the moment, so that's going to be an announcement for the future.
Now, where there are competitors, there is consolidation. Are you anticipating consolidation within the industry?
Well, I constantly ask that. When I talk competitors, the truth is there is only one competitor. He is in two parts, but he consolidated. That has caused some consternation amongst the customers. I famous last words, I don't know, but I would be surprised if the authorities would allow, I would be surprised if the vehicle manufacturers would allow the authorities to allow further consolidation in what is currently a monopoly situation in the industry.
Now, finally, what is the return on investment story in a nutshell?
Oh, in a nutshell, this is a 1 billion market. Our customer, our competitor, forgive me, is 60 million in sales and we're a million. And we are raising, ultimately, it'll take, ultimately cost about 3 million to build a plant to demonstrate in that marketplace that we could all make a lot of money out of this, and do not underestimate the scale of our ambition in this £1 billion market.
David Bundred, Chairman of Surface Transforms, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you.